All right. Hey, guys, thanks for joining us today. We're going to be talking about the lead conversion arc in Next Level Suite and really in any CRM database that you would be using for your business. We're going to show you how you get people in there and how you communicate with them. And not only that, why is it important to communicate with those people? I'd love to have you stick with us the entire time. We do have an offer for you at the end if you want to stick around and take advantage of that. So we're going to talk about the lead conversion arc, ARC, acquire, respond, and communicate. And you've read the 5+1 book with Chaz Wilson. You'll hear more about this lead conversion arc and actually a lot more about business, building your business in general. Highly recommend it. And today we're going to focus on this lead conversion arc. So how do you acquire, respond, and communicate with your leads? And ultimately, what that's going to do is lead to some sort of agreement, whether that's a face-to-face meeting or a follow-up or close business is ultimately what everyone is looking for in the business world. So how do you do that? How do you get through this entire process and seal that deal or close that sale? So you acquire everyone, the A. You want to put everyone, including the kitchen sink, into your database. So this is people in your world, everywhere you are. If you're at your kid's sporting event, if you're at a networking event, you're at church, you're getting groceries, anywhere that you meet people, they're great people to put into your database. Now, that's not to say that you're going to market and communicate to every single person the exact same way. You need to be smart about that. You don't want to send the same emails to your current customers that to someone that you just met in the grocery store. That's going to be a huge turnoff unless that person has really indicated extreme interest. But when you do meet people, you want to share with them what you're doing, because so often the people closest to us don't know exactly what we're doing, and it's missed opportunities, missed business from the people that are closest to us because we're insecure, not sharing what we do. And so they don't know. And it's not intentional that they don't hire us or use our services, but it's because they don't know what it is we're doing. So making sure that you're putting everyone into your database, you're marketing and sharing information with them based on what their interest level is, if they've done business with you in the past, if they seem highly interested, all of that communication will be a little bit different than someone you met at, we'll say, church or the grocery store, but making that information available to them. And then how do you respond to anyone? So you want to respond quickly. We live in an instant gratification world, and people want that immediate response. So if you're not responding quickly, even if it is an automated response, and people know it's an automated response, and that's fine, but they want something in return. So if they fill out a contact me form or lead capture page, landing page, on your website or social media, you have something that automatically goes out to them. And you can say in there, whatever your protocol is for following up with them, we'll be in contact with you within 4 hours or 2 business days or whatever it is. And you also need to keep in mind, what is the product or service you offer? If you're in something highly competitive, or let's say you're a plumber and you say, I'll get back to you in 2 business days, you know, I have a leaky sink or my toilet is running and flooding my bathroom, I'm not going to wait 2 days for you to get back to me. So you need to be aware of that and making sure that you're following up based on what that emergent need is of people. And also know that if you're going to take 2 days to respond to someone, chances are they're going to find someone else. So just being upfront so people know what to expect, they know where you're at with things. And or you can also offer, hey, if this is an emergency, here is my personal cell or here is my personal email. Here's how you can reach me by text message to get that immediate response, because now they have that connection with you and they feel that they got the permission to contact you, even if it is on Saturday or Sunday or holiday or whatever it is, and they're going to respond to you. They're going to appreciate that. So thinking about where in your world can you use automation? Where can you have things that automatically go so that people are getting their instant gratification? And then how do you get notified? So when someone fills out a lead capture page form, you as the account holder, are you getting a notification? So if you are out in a place, you can immediately call that person or email that person personally. Will make a huge, huge difference. So thinking about how do you respond and how efficient are you in making sure that everyone knows what is coming? And then how do you communicate? How do you communicate with all of the people that you've met in your world? You want to send out offers because people like offers, like referrals. So if you send out an offer that says, hey, if you use my service, you get this, or if you refer me to someone, you'll get this, and that person is going to get this. That makes them look like the hero. So I can share this offer with all of my friends. I'm going to get rewarded, but I'm also going to look like a hero to all of my friends because I just gave them the best person in the industry. I gave them a great solid referral and they're going to be happy and more likely to refer as well. So thinking about how you can generate that excitement, how you can reward those best customers, those best connectors or referrers in your world, and making sure that you're keeping them happy and taking care of the people in their world. Because the people who are the best referrers are good connectors and they have a lot of people in their world and are usually highly respected and influential people. So those are the ones that you want to butter up, communicate with, and make sure that they are on your good side. So, and not always making it a sale. You don't always want to have a hard sale or even a soft sale in your offers that you have in your communications. You want to make it something informational. So we all are the experts in our field. And what is common sense for us may be completely foreign to someone else. And it often is. You know, we think that we don't need to share that information because everyone knows it. But that's not always true. So for example, a lot of people will keep their garden hoses hooked up to the spigots outside of their house and not think about it when the temperature drops in the fall and all of a sudden it freezes. And now either in the fall or the spring when it does thaw out, they have burst pipes in their basement. When a plumber could have sent out just, hey, don't forget, the temperatures are dropping. Make sure you unhook your hoses, drain them, put them away for the season so you don't burst your pipes. Or have you changed the filter in your furnace from your HVAC guy? Have you serviced your air conditioner before you turned it on? Because you never know what rodents may have moved into your air conditioning unit and you're going to burn it up and ruin it. So these things that we wouldn't think of personally as a homeowner, and honestly, we all have so much going on in our worlds, we don't want to have to think about all those things. But if we get those reminders, could save us a lot of money, and it's going to also give us a lot of respect for the person who took the time to share that bit of knowledge, although common sense to us, to them isn't necessarily common sense to us. So communicate with all the people in your world. And then ultimately, your goal is to set up those meetings and that follow-up. If you can get a face-to-face meeting with someone, these are huge. This is really where all of the magic takes place. You want to meet face-to-face with people because so much more comes from it. People let their guards down. They feel connected to you and they're going to share more things. And this is really where you can develop opportunities. If you share what your pain points are or who a good referral is for you, they're going to think about that. They're going to feel connected to you and they're going to want to refer themselves or the people in their world to you. So trying to get those face-to-face meetings and set up that time where you can really connect with people. And then being able to track what is being opened, what links are being clicked on, what videos are being watched. So knowing what's going on with the information that you send to people, you'll be able to see who's highly interested. This really comes into play with those that are introverted. You're going to see them explode. They're going to be opening things up. They're going to be closing it. They're going to be opening up. They're going to be watching it. They're going to be reviewing it. They're going to be interested, but you may not hear from them. When you see that they have all this action going on and they receive something personalized from you, a text message, a phone call, a personalized email, they're more likely to sign up with you, to hire you, because you've reached out to them. They felt connected to you, which is why they were opening things and reviewing things and analyzing things often. But now that you've reached out to them and connected with them, that takes a huge burden off of them because they don't have to pick up the phone call and make that call to you. And they don't have to look for someone else, which is even more scary for them. So being aware of what's going on and reaching out to those people that are showing that they're interested. And then also if they're not interested, if they've unsubscribed, don't hunt them down or try to continue to call them because they unsubscribed. It's okay. You can reach out and say, you know, is it something that I said? Is there something, you know, you didn't find value in it? You can definitely learn from those opportunities as well. But don't freak people out. Don't overwhelm them. Don't be a constant hard sale. So what is my offer to you today? Yes, I am going to put an offer in here. I'm going to offer you a free, private, no obligation demonstration. If you go to our website, www.nlsuite.com, and click on the schedule demo button, you'll be able to meet with us one-on-one, and we'll walk through, find out more about your business, how you could use Next Level Suite or another CRM to grow your business. Now, we don't do hard sales. We do free trials. We will meet you where you're at, and we're also going to give you 40% off of your membership for life. So you sign up, we're going to take 40% off your cost, and you're going to have that every single month for the entire time that you are a customer of ours. We believe in partnerships, not prisoners. We do month to month. So if you get started and decide it's not for you, you can cancel at any time. You can suspend your account if you're feeling like, I'm not into this right now, whatever your reasoning is, we're here to help you. And that is really ultimately our goal. We're not going to push you into something that we don't feel is appropriate. And if we think a basic level is right for you, that's what we're going to tell you. We're not going to tell you you need the top level with all the bells and whistles because we're realists. We're business people too. We're entrepreneurs and we want to help you. So we'd love to connect with you. Check out the website, schedule your demo, and know that we will be here to support you along the way. So I hope you guys have a great day. You can also reach out to me personally, Sherry, Sherry, @nlsuite.com. I would love to hear from you and looking forward. Have a great day.